Well, I think that perception or that reality, Anand, in many ways, has to be not what is necessarily being marketed, but what the ground reality is. And I believe in our country, the way I look at things, a country which has a 5,000-year-old civilizational history, there has to be a foundation and a bedrock of tolerance, of diversity, of liberal views, and it's on that bedrock and that foundation of secularism, of tolerance, of liberal views that you can build economic verticals that will then power the country forward. The UPA government in many ways was inspired by that very thought and action. Today, if you look at the environment in the country, one of complete intolerance, and what is the biggest tragedy is that it is being fueled by the current establishment. You'll ask me how. When incidents happen and responsible people in positions of government and power make irresponsible statements, and then those statements are not negated, that creates an environment in which anything goes. And that's what you've seen India turn into in the last 3 years. Whether you look at multiple incidents where you're told in India today what you have to say, what you have to eat, how you have to dress, it's almost like a code that's been mandated down to 125 crore Indians. If you speak up against this, you're labeled as anti-nationalist. So there is no, in a democracy, and this is, I think, what President Mukherjee in your lecture yesterday also talked about, there is no voice that can be raised which has a different opinion. And I think if that tolerant spirit of India dies, then I think something in each one of us dies. You look at the way today Dalits are being treated in this country. On the one hand, this government talks about holding a special session to celebrate Baba Sahib Ambedkar's Jayanti, holding meetings in Mau, and at the same time you've got atrocities happening across the country. And in reaction to that, you have BJP leaders speaking up against this and saying that this is the right thing to happen. You have leaders of the current establishment saying that reservation must be done away with. So I think that their logic is not necessarily a Congress Mukt Bharat, but a Dalit Mukt and an Adivasi Mukt Bharat. You've got love jihad happening in this country, you've got ghar vapsi happening in this country, you've got incidents like Kerana happening, incidents like Saranpur happening, what happened in Jharkhand, in Jamshedpur, and the government is completely silent across all parameters. Gaurakshaks running rampage across this country, incidents in Una, Pehlu Khan in Alwar. So it's an atmosphere of fear that has built up in this country. And in an atmosphere of fear, you cannot achieve any progress. Not only that, but if you look at the issues of internal security, you look at the issues of foreign policy, you look at the issues of defense, agriculture, employment, economy, across the board, this government has failed across multiple counts. And I think during our discussion, we'll get into those facets individually, because each one of those facets is extremely important. In the case of internal security, if you look at what's happening in Kashmir, it's become a unholy situation where you have an unholy government to start with, and then you have total paralysis in terms of different voices within the same coalition speaking. Post the Pathankot incident, you've had Lieutenant General Philip Campos's report that has come out, that has looked at 3,000 army installations that require 2,000 crore of funding to make them secure. 1.5 years have passed, not one rupee has been spent. If you look at the issue of foreign policy, we don't know what we are doing on the Pakistan front. Sometimes we say, chappan inch ki chhati, then we do sari shawl diplomacy, then we call ISI officers to investigate the Pathankot incident. If you look at the issue of China, China is encircling this country with its string of pearls strategy, whether it's investment in Bangladesh, in Sri Lanka, giving 2 submarines to Myanmar, this whole CPC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, One Belt, One Road, negating us on every front, whether it's the NSG proposal that we put forward, Masood Azhar, and we are just left standing around as bystanders. On the issue of defense, lowest defense budget since 1962, 1.62% of GDP. Only 80,000 crores towards capex, of which 90% is already committed to earlier deals that we have struck, whether it's Vikramaditya, Sukhoi, the Rafael deal. So you've got hardly 8,000 crores or 10,000 crores left over for annual funding for capex. How is the army going to progress in that front? You look at agriculture, farmers' suicides across this country. You look at fall in rates of MSP, the same party that talked about doubling farm income, talked about giving 50% above cost in terms of MSP as outlined in the Swaminathan report. And then they send the AG to court saying that this is impossible to do. So across the board, you've got strife, you've got angst. Unemployment is the biggest issue in this country today. You promised 2 crore jobs per year. Last 3 years, your record is between 4 lakh jobs a year to 1.35 lakhs last year, which is not even 1% of the target that you set out for yourself. So where is that Achhe Din, and when is that Achhe Din concept going to come? When is the concept going to come of Sabka Saath and Sabka Vikas?